You're going to play Lincoln Sudbury Friday.
If they win that, then they go to the Super Bowl.
Since I've been in town.
I guess, I mean, they're the one seed right into the two.
Oh, okay.
But.
How many times have they been to the Super Bowl? It's like the Patriots, right? It's like every other year they go to the Super Bowl.
Test.
I can't hear myself.
Yeah, but we got a lot of good players.
No, in the high school class,
right?
You overturned every 3 years.
Oh, yeah, sure.
You have a year, you can have
Room
by Robert McCormick for a loss of 1 yard. Second down.
We got a lot of superstars coming up. This 18 is great.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
Are you recording now, Brian?
No, I'm just trying to figure something out. Okay, welcome to Wilmington High School, where we have Reading taking on the Sauga Sachems. Is that what it is, Todd? Do I have it right? We played them earlier in the year. We have our captains on the field. We have Aiden Beckenhuis. We have Joe Puelli. Colby Goodchild. Josh Robichard. James Murphy. And Rocco Marciarelli are our captains today. Six captains. After a big win for the final regular season game last week against Woburn, a team we played in the preseason, and Reading really dominated that play. Colby had six touchdowns and moving the ball up and down the field, and great defensive play, great blocking. It was really a great win to cap off the season. Now we go to the playoffs and we take on a team that we lost to earlier in the season and by 1 point. And I don't, if there was any team that Reading would want to take on again, I think this is it, because that's a game they felt like they could have had. So, very exciting. So let's see who's going to be kicking off and returning. So, Reading wins the toss, declines. They're going to kick off. And we'll be back in a moment to start this ball game. Okay, we're set for kickoff. And Giacomo Iapica is getting ready, resetting the ball. We got the whole broadcast team in the booth here today. Again, as Coach Marciarelli is looking for helpers down on the field, they need more parental assistance, and it looks like we have Chuck Strout, and who else going down? They got a couple volunteers, huh? And Rob Murphy's going down too, so we got a couple parents. Gino Grande, all right. The crowd applauds. Well, this is exciting. About a 50-degree day, overcast. They need him on the field.
On the chains?
Yep. Right, so they're going to be working the chains. Molly's leaving the booth. Are we offline?
No, we're still kicking.
All right. Molly's leaving the booth to go do some photography down there. We'll see you down there, Molly. I can't believe he did that. Chuck left the camera right on the field.
We lost a member of our broadcast crew. Lost a member of the broadcast crew.
Yep, here we go. We're still live, Todd, huh?
Still live.
Here we go, kickoff. Playoffs have begun for Reading. The Sachems field the ball cleanly. Got a little running room. And Aiden Beckenhuis makes the tackle. So the Sachems will take over on their own 40-yard line. And we see the defense taking the field here. We have Jesse Daugherty coming out. Alec Grande. Colin Donnie, who's out there. Joe Puelli. And our first play from scrimmage right now. And a tight formation, we remember, from earlier in the season, in the second week of the season, right up the middle. Maybe a gain of one or two. It'll be second down and eight. Second and eight for Reading, or for Saugus, excuse me. It's a handoff to the left side. And he's taken down, maybe no gain or a loss. It's going to be third and long. Some great defensive play by Redding. Third down and eight. Poeli's running over to cover the slot position. Shotgun. He's looking to throw. He has an open guy. Number 54 is running. And on the tackle, Kobe Goodchild. It's going to bring up a fourth down and about five or six. Fourth down. And they're going for it. Fourth down from their own 45. There's a false snap. Do they call a penalty?
Maybe they'd call them offsides.
It's offsides on them, it looks like. Let's see here. Let's see what the call. We saw one of the defensive players encroach, but it looks like he got back. It's true. It won't be a first down, even if it's against him. A little huddle by the refs. I think they just called a, they saw a jump by the defensive lineman, but he got back. So now the offense gets in the game. And yeah, some little reaction by the crowd. Okay, we have a defensive front in the game here. I see Max Leone out wide right, playing cornerback. Carter Learned on the left side. Oh, split right wide receiver, excuse me. Handoff up the middle. It's Ben Wright. He's got about 6-7 yards. Does he have a first down? Great run. Good and short for Redding after that great pickup by Ben Wright. Good blocking up front by Redding. Rocco into center. Another handoff up the middle. Ben Wright has the first down. They're moving the chains. Look at this team. Okay, first down. First down of the game. Rocco into center. He's got Iapika and Ben Wright. It's a pitch to Ben Wright to the left. He has the corner. He turns it up. He's got a first down and about 13-yard pickup for Redding. What a play. They're moving the ball. Some good blocking up front and great running. Beckenhuis, the halfback. Ben Wright all the way back. It's to Ben Wright again. He's got a few yards. Positive play every time here. They're moving it. Gain of a couple. Was that Colby? No, that wasn't Colby. That was Ben Wright. Second down at about eight for Redding. We see Matt DeCourcy in at center. We have Zach Galvin as a left tackle. Tight end, Joe Puelli. It's a pitch to Kobe Goodchild. They were keying on him. Tackle for a loss. It's going to be third and about 12 for Redding. Also in the line of scrimmage, we have Jason Anderson, right tackle. Ben Hennessy, right guard. Max Leone split out right. It's a pitch to Kobe Goodchild. He goes to the left. He's turned it up. He's got the corner. He's going to have the first down and more. Is he going to make it? Almost. Pushed out of bounds with just a few yards to go. It looks like it's going to be first down and goal from about the 5-yard line. We only have one headset here, which is awkward for me. I like to throw it to the color commentators. I'm with Tom Dolan on my right here and Todd Rainbow on the camera to my left. I played on this field as a high school player, Thanksgiving Day game every year. Brings back some emotional nice memories for me, Tom.
That's what you said, Dave.
There you go.
Okay, first and goal. It's a run, and it looks like Colby's going to go in for 6 points. And we have the first points of the playoffs for Redding at 6-0.
Colby Goodchild, seventh touchdown in the last seven touchdowns we've got.
That's right. So his seventh touchdown in the last 5 quarters.
Keep it rolling.
Oh, okay, we'll keep it going here. The Redding offense likes to do hurry up even when they're going for an extra point. And it's going to be going for one. We have Ben Wright deep. Aiden Beckenhuyson at the halfback spot. Here we got Max Loney right. It looks like Andrew Topier on the left wide receiver. It's a pitch to Ben Wright. He turns it up. They got it covered. So it'll be 6-0, and we'll come back for the kickoff. All right, we're just joined by Coach Fidale from the B team in the booth here. He's impressed with the early play by Redding. Kickoff by Ayapik. It's an onside kick, and it's fielded cleanly by Saugus. They'll take over at their own 48-yard line. Live. Okay, we have Saugus taking over on their own 49-yard line, first and 10. It's a pitch to the right side. And they're swarming. It's Puelli's in on the tackle. Who else is over there? I see Jesse Daugherty popping up there. I think he might have been. And Kobe Goodchild as well. All right, it'll be second and about 12, second and 11 for Saugus. We played this team so close when we had them in Saugus early in the year. All right, they're going to their split set now. A little surprise element by Saugus. He's under center. Quarterback keeper. And they're not fooled.
Any flags? Saugus had too many men on the field.
Yep, Alec Grande in the tackle, and Fidale, Coach Fidale's noticing that they might have too many men on the field there.
Ran off the field as they were snapping the ball.
Yep.
I'm sure Coach Mush is yelling about that.
Oh, yeah, I think he is right now. It's it's 3rd and 9 for Saugus. Right on the 50-yard line. And it's a timeout for Saugus. Okay, 3rd and long. Let's see if Redding can hold him again here. Although it looks like this would be 4-down territory. It's a handoff to the right side. Oh, it's a double option there. A nice tackle. Kobe Goodchild wasn't fooled. He stayed on the pitch, man. Took that out of bounds. It's going to be 4th down at about 7. 4th and 7 for Saugus. Defense has played great so far. He's looking to throw. Pressure by DiNapoli. It's picked off. That's James Murphy for the pickoff. He's had a few this year, and they're going to take over their own 45-yard line. Pressure on the quarterback, and I think that might have forced a bad throw, and James Murphy was right in position to pick that off. After a little bobble, he came down with it, and they'll take over here at their own 45-yard line. Murphy's in at quarterback for the first time. Rocco had the first drive for a touchdown. Led that drive. We have Beckenhuyson in motion. And it's a reverse to DiNapoli. Gets around one guy and turns it upfield. And he's going to have about 10, 12 yards. First down. DiNapoli made that first guy miss and really turned that into something. They're taking it under center. The weather's looking a little, it's kind of turning a little bit here. It looks like we get a little precipitation. And again, Beckenhuyson in motion, as usual. It's a handoff up the middle. Number 19 was all over Kobe Goodchild. So that's going to be tackled for a loss. Going to take it and make it 2nd and 12. Okay. Okay. All right, 2nd and 12 after some A-gap penetration on that play for a loss. Shotgun to Murphy. He's looking deep. Oh, chose to the short guy, and was that Beckenhuyson, but tackled right as he catches the ball. He really didn't get any clearance. That was Goodchild. So it's going to be 3rd and about 14 for Redding. Paulie checking off. Todd, thanks for giving me a little running room. You let me run with the line more than Molly does. She cuts me right off after the play, and I like to embellish. Take comments.
We like to listen to you, Dave.
Set the scene, Dave. Set the scene.
Third and long. Ayapika checks, make sure he's on the line of scrimmage with that hand signal. I like that play. It's a fake handoff. Murphy doesn't fool anybody with that, and it's going to be 4th and forever for Redding. Okay, Coach Marsharelli calls for the punt at midfield, playing it conservative here early with a 6-0 lead. Smart play here. Make them show something on offense. Waiting for the snap. Joe Puelli is the long snapper. He's done a nice job as a long snapper this year. And here's the snap. It's a good one. The kick is up, down the field pretty good, and it's fair caught or kneeled down right away. So they'll take over in their own 35-yard line. That was the end of the first quarter, so we switch sides as Saugus will take over after a nice punt by Giacomo. They'll take over in their own 35, first and 10. It's a handoff up the middle. They had a little gap there, but 5-yard pickup, and Rocco makes sure it doesn't turn into more. Nice tackle by Rocco Marciarelli. Second and 5 for Saugus. The power running game is definitely their game. Well, they did beat us on some big throws last game. Nothing this time, though. Maybe a couple. It'll be 3rd and 3.
Legs kept on moving. Got a couple extra.
Yep, kept pumping. Okay, we have Max Rizza checking out of the game.
Yeah, 51.
Eamon Centrella checks in on the line. Joe Puelli as a linebacker. We also have Dylan Sweetser on the line of scrimmage as well. And Jesse Daugherty playing left defensive end, or left, maybe an outside linebacker. Hard to tell by that positioning. Quarterback keeper right up the middle, and they're going to move it. I think they're pushing the pile all the way to a first down, using their power running game. And it'll be their first down, I believe. Okay, we have 1st and 10 for the Sachems. They do have some beef up front, it seems. It's another handoff up the middle. And Redding seems to have this one covered pretty well. Maybe a gain of a yard and a half, so it'll be 2nd and 8. Todd, I had trouble doing the math after that 2-yard pickup. 2nd and 8, I have it here. Oh, I think we have an offsides call here. Movement on the offensive line, and we reacted to it, so they're going to move him back 5. As they're discussing this. Oh, did they? They called it against us.
It's ready.
We'll call it when we come back, once they move it.
You're on.
Oh, okay. That was a 5-yard penalty. I thought we were off air. Sorry about that. We are a little internal broadcast dialogue.
I should have got it.
So, thank God we kept it clean. I thought it was online.
Todd keeps it rolling.
Todd lets me run with the line. It's going to be 2nd and 3 for the Sachems after that 5-yard penalty. I don't think it was personally offsides. I think we got back in time and we were reacting to them. It's a handoff up the middle. No gain. Maybe a loss of 1. It's going to be 3rd down and 4. Defense is playing really well today. Burns on the nose right now. 3rd and 5 for the Sachems. They take it right up the middle. And maybe pick up a couple. I mean, they've run that play a lot now. It's just like a quarterback sneak and just...
I think they're using their size.
Yeah, they're using
their
size.
Big back.
It'll be 4th down. So I notice the defensive coach, Puelli, shifted in some of the girth in the middle now. We've got some of our bigger guys playing the defensive front, as Todd and Tom just pointed out to me. It seems like that's their game. It's the power up the middle. So we see Alec Grande in there. We see Eamon Centrella. We're starting to clog the middle a little bit here. 4th and 4. Or 3. A little confusion, and they're going to take a timeout on the other side. Okay, 4th down. We have Josh Robichaud in the game on the defensive line. Dylan Sweetser.
Big stop, big
Rocco Marciarelli. It's a fake handoff to the left, and he's got running room. Uh-oh, he could go all the way unless Rocco can get him. Rocco's got a little bit of an edge. Can he get him? No, he's going to make it in for a touchdown. 6-6. You know, they were bottling up the middle. They kind of set us up for that because they brought it outside knowing we were going to clog the middle. So it was good strategy by Saugus. We got a ball game, 6-6.
Is this where I should take over the camera?
Saugus going for the extra point. They're going to go for 2. I think they made a kick against us in the regular season.
I think they did.
The ball is down. The kick is up. And it's good. So they take the lead, 8-6. We'll be expecting Rainey to come back and get these points back.
their next extra point. I think I'm going to go sit down in that.
Okay, we are ready for the kick reception here. A bit of a hybrid kick, kind of an onside floater, and it's going to be taken by Alex Napoli. Fielded it cleanly. We'll take over at our own 45-yard line. To 10 for Reading at their own 44-yard line. Murphy's under center. He's got Goodchild alone setback. Beckenhuis in motion. Fake handoff to Beckenhuis. Gobi Goodchild takes it. Breaks a few tackles and somehow makes positive yards out of that play after being swarmed in the backfield. So elusive. Second and six for Reading. A long six. Shotgun to Murphy. He's got Goodchild to his left. He's got Puelli split out left. It's a handoff to Goodchild. Breaks a couple tackles, turns it up, has some running room, and gets a first down to the 43-yard line. Nice run by Colby. Speaking of Colby, what a play last week we saw where he strip tackled a guy going in for a touchdown and then recovered it and then started running it back for about 25 yards. We thought that was the play of the season. And then they scored after that, so it was a 12-point swing. And now we have Murphy under center. Oh, he draws them offside with a hard count. And they call the play dead. Yep, they get the 5-yard penalty. Nicely done. And all the players showed some discipline by not moving at all when Murphy did the hard count. Nicely done by Redding. It's the little things that can make a turn something into a victory, and that's a smart play right there. Pick up a quick 5 yards. Now it's just first and five. Coach Murphy calling him to play to his son out there. Looks like a change of play. Beckenhuis in motion. We see that a lot. Oh, he reverses direction. And it's a pitch to Goodchild. He turns up. He finds his lane. He has running room. He has a first down and more. Maybe about a 15-yard pickup all the way to the 21. Nice run. Okay, Rocco Marciarelli subs in for Beckenhuis as the slot. Oh, running back. We have Iapica split out left and DiNapoli out right. It's a handoff up the middle to Kobe Goodchild. Maybe a pickup of three, and it'll be second and seven for Reading.
It'd be interesting to see if they go for the 2-point conversion.
Oh, yeah. Let's go live. Okay, we have Strout and Puelli checking in as the wide receivers. Strout out left, Puelli out right. Rocco's in the slot. James Murphy comes to talk to his dad about a play call here. A lot of communication between them in this series. Gets Marciarelli in motion. It's the Edelman play, and he turns it to a few yards, maybe a 5-yard pickup, 6-yard pickup. It'll be third down and short for Reading. Their offense is clicking. DiNapoli checks in for Puelli. Strout moves to the other side. A lot of players changing in and out we see here. Colin Donahue at center. Trying to do the hard count again. Doesn't draw them off. Kobe Goodchild has some running room. He's gone. Touchdown, Reading. It's going to be 12-8. Nice offensive series. They really put together some nice plays and good play calling and execution. The blocking and the play calling, it was fantastic. Nice drive for Reading. Okay, Reading is setting up to do the 2-point conversion, it looks like. Or are they making a decision? No, maybe not. Nope, they've decided against it. I thought with Ferrado going in, who sometimes kicks, he was going to be setting up to kick the 2 points. So they're down 12-8, and they're going to go for the 1-point conversion with three running backs. It goes to Goodchild, a couple blockers ahead of him. He turns it up the field, and they're going to be short. So it'll be 12-8 as we have 2 minutes left in the half, 2 minutes and 13 seconds. Great drive. And great just to have the Reading team come back and score and answer that. Oh, it's an onside kick and it's recovered by Reading.
That was clean.
Who comes up with it?
Reading's got it.
Who is that? That was 51. That's Eamon Centrella. recovering the onside kick.
There he is. Let's zoom in on him.
Zoom in on Amon. What a play. What a turn of events after being down 8-6 and then taking the ensuing kickoff and running it all the way down the field to take the lead. And now kicking off again and an onside kick recovered. This is great for Reading. What an opportunity. With 2 minutes left, they can get some more points. We have Jesse Daugherty as the tight end on the left side. And we have Ryan Strout split left. And Joe Puelli split right.
Good time to bust one.
Kobe Goodchild alone setback. I think that's Rocco Masciarelli in the slot. No, it was Beck and Hughes. And it's a pass to Kobe Goodchild. A swing pass, a screen pass. He makes it 10 yards and more. Oh, could he take this all the way? He's at the 30. He's at the 20. 10. He's gone. Kobe Goodchild for 6 points.
What a cut.
18-8. Unbelievable cut.
Turn on like a
nickel. What a run. This Reading team is psyched. We're looking at him in the sidelines here, jumping up and down. Imagine that with 2 minutes left to go and an onside kick and turn it in to another 6 points. So let's see what they go for here. It looks like they're looking for advice from Coach Murphy on the play call here. And they're going to go for one. They got Puelli split out left. I'm going to call this play, Todd and Tom. I think it's going to Jesse Daugherty for the one-point conversion. They're going to go to our tight end right here. That's what I believe. He's looking to throw. He has an open receiver. It's knocked down. It was to Beck and Hughes, but somebody got in the middle and knocked it down. So with a minute and 33 seconds left, we'll have an 18-8 lead for Reading. Another onside kick, maybe, guys? Yep. I think they're going to deep kick this time. We'll see. Take a look at the cheerleaders doing their push-ups again. We've been seeing this every game now. The cheerleaders in their power game. I think they do that every time they score a touchdown. They do the push-ups. Life. Set for kickoff. Exciting ball game for Reading. Ayapika kicks it deep this time. I called that. And they're going to just cover it up. They didn't want to give them really good field position. So they'll take over on their own 32-yard line. Okay, we have Sean Murphy checking into the game. Max Rizza, Jordan Whitmer. We have DiNapoli on the right end. And who's the left end? Oh, it's Jesse Daugherty, the left end, I believe. Yeah. And we have Puelli and Murphy covering the receivers, playing the slot and the wide receiver. It's a shotgun. They're looking deep. Puelli's on the coverage and breaks it up. Nice play by Joe Puelli. Is that a timeout? That's timeout. Cheerleaders doing a little acrobatics right here. We got a big catch. Nicely done. The championship team, I think they're in the playoffs. They were last week anyway. Hopefully they're still continuing on. I know they went to the regionals. So we got a timeout on the field with just a minute left, it looks like, and it's 2nd and 10 for the Sachems. Hopefully we can keep them off the board. And back to the cheerleaders. Got the whole group here now, Todd. Todd's doing some great camera work.
Let it ride.
All right, now we're back to the field of play. Dylan Sweetser checks back into the game. Nice wrap up by Dylan Sweetser. Jeez, I called his name just as he was about to make a tackle. Don't worry, we're not on delay. That was just great anticipation by the broadcast team. Todd actually called it. He whispered in my ear. All right, it'll be 3rd down and 12 for Saugus. Tom Dolan's really itchy to get behind the camera, but while Reading still has the lead, we're not going to take it away from Tom, from Todd. Todd has it.
This game is all Todd.
It's all Todd.
Oh, timeout. Oh, no, is that the end? Nope, timeout.
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 Yep. What could be the last play of the game here with, it says 17 seconds left on the game clock, the field clock. We don't know if it's, the half, yeah. Tom corrects me. 17 seconds left in the half, and We do have a deep guy back just to make sure nothing. Oh, it's a loose ball. And it's fourth down. They recovered it. Okay, we have 13 seconds left on the stadium clock. We don't know what the official time is, but this is fourth down and long. Kobe Goodchild way back deep just to make sure nothing breaks. But I think Redding actually called a timeout there, thinking if they can take over here on downs, they have a shot to get some more points. So it's a shotgun snap. He's looking. He has an open receiver for a completion and not a first down. So they get the offense back out on the field.
Call a timeout, looks like.
They don't have the half. We have Murphy and shotgun. They're going to take one more shot and see if they can get more points in the half. And he's looking. He's rolling right. He has an open man. And that's Ryan Strout, who runs out of bounds. Is there any time left? There is. There's 20 seconds, so it looks like there was an adjustment between the stadium clock and the official time. So now Redding has a first down, and they're on their own on Saugus' 25-yard line. First and 10. Maybe one or two plays left here. It's a handoff to Kobe Goodchild to the left side. He has running room. He finds his gap. He's gone. Another 6 points for Kobe Goodchild. It's going to be 24-8. Wow. What a series there. Redding calling timeouts while the other team had the ball, expecting to take over and get some more points, and it paid off. So they're going for one. We have Murphy under center. We have Iapika and Wright in the backfield. Poeli split out left. It's a pitch to Ben Wright, and he has some running room. I think he can make this if he turns it up. Did he get in there? They say no. They say no. Right on the line, right on the goal line. Yeah, we would like to see a replay on that one. And it's a challenge flag on the field, Todd Ramos says, but it's not allowed. So exciting way to end this half. Maybe a squib kickoff to end the half. There's 8 seconds left.
I think we should go for another onside kick.
Yeah.
Let's get the score here. Here we go.
And we have the score, 24-8. 10 seconds left to go. I'm sure we'll have Iapika just squib it up there, and we don't want to run back. And I would think they'd just kneel it down. Ben Wright got banged up a little bit on that last play. Boy, he really tried to power it over and get that extra point. Oh, yeah. And we're set for kickoff with a 24-8 lead, 10 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter. Iapika, just his squib kick. Make sure there's no return, and the Sachems will take over with just maybe enough time for one more snap. First and 10 for the Sachems. Looks like they're not going to kneel it down. They're in a shotgun position here, and they're throwing the ball deep, and it's incomplete. Murphy had good coverage on him, and maybe there's one more play left. It says there's only a few seconds left, 3 seconds left, probably the last play of the half. I keep on saying that, but the half keeps on going on and on. Didn't we say there was like 20 seconds left like a half hour ago? And we've since then, we've taken it over the ball, ran it in, and now they've had a couple plays. Kickoff. Now there's 30 seconds back on the clock. The half that will never end. Second and 10. Who do they have really deep there? Is that Rocco? They haven't played Rocco play really deep, 10 yards back. They're throwing deep, and Murphy's on coverage. He tips it away. He's really comfortable on the defensive pass plays, Murphy. He always seems to get his hand on it or an interception.
Throws it and defends it.
Yep. We got Rowan Manahan checking in the game. And Jordan Whitmer checking out. Colin Donahue on the nose, it looks like. And I noticed they moved Colin right up front. Sometimes he plays in that linebacker position. Against this team, they've moved him up a little bit because they like to run up the middle. Poeli coming back into the middle of the field as a linebacker position. It's a handoff up the middle. And it'll be fourth and 10. And they call that the half. So that's the end of the half. And as Todd zooms in on the scoreboard, it's 24-8, and the Reading team is congratulating each other after a great half. They're pretty psyched about this, as they should be. What a great game so far. So we have halftime. Ready for kickoff. We have Reading receiving the kickoff. It's nice when you defer and you have the lead coming out of the second half, and it's a deep kickoff. And it looks like that is Ryan Strout, and he's got maybe a yard, 10-yard back, almost 10 yards. Good run back. Reading will take over. It'll be first and 10 from their own 40-yard line, and with a 24-8 lead. Nice way to start the second half, huh, Todd?
Absolutely. Great start.
You're going to have to be louder than that with this microphone, Todd, if you want to say something. We only got the one microphone. Okay, we have Max Leone spit out left, and we have, who's out right? Is that? I think that's Andrew Topier split out right. Rocco Marciarelli into center. It's a handoff up the middle. Ben Wright, he has some yards. He's going to get about 6 yards on that. He's hitting the line hard today. He looks like he's ready to run, Ben Wright. On offense, we have Matt DeCourcy as center. I see that we had Thomas Frado as the left tight end. We'll get some more of the players' names to you in between this next play. Todd will let it run for me. Marciarelli hands it off the middle to Ben Wright. No gain this time. Sean Murphy, it looks like he's at a tackle. We got Ben Hennessy at right guard. Jack Ramo is in, usually tight end.
He's coming in, yeah.
Jack Ramo.
Right side. Who else? Number 9, that's Topier.
Topia's in there. Topia. Jack Ramo moves to the left's tight end. We have Zach Galvin, also left tackle. Rocco Marciarelli under center. It's a pitch to Kobe Goodchild. He makes a couple moves, makes the first people miss, and he breaks it again. Here he goes. It looks too easy. He's going in for a touchdown. Kobe Goodchild. It's going to be 30-8. Great blocking up front. Let's look at the linemen that are in here. Zoom in on those offensive linemen that broke that for him. We got Sean Murphy out there, 41. Jason Anderson. Ben Hennessy, Matt DeCourcy was doing some of that blocking, Zach Galvin. I think that's, we have Jack Ramo doing some of the blocking as well. And they're waiting for the play call coming in. Jack Ramo in tight end. And we also have Carter Learned split out left and Andrew Topier out right. And I can't underscore the blocking of the outside receivers too, because they certainly were involved in that play as well. Made some good blocks. Rocco rolls out, and he has it to Jack Ramo. No? What? Oh. It looked like he was in. He had it. They have squeezed us on two extra points now, because it looked like Ben Wright got in, and it looked like Jack Ramo had it as well. He definitely came down with the ball, and he looked like he landed on the goal line.
Challenge flag.
Yep. Todd Ramo in the booth is calling the challenge flag, because he thought his son deserved that. And I agree with him. And I'll tell you, he's getting some congratulations on the sideline. So they, all of the team, assumes he got that one.
I didn't really see it. I think I got it on camera.
Yeah, you did. I think you got it on camera. It looks like you were focused in. So Reading quickly starts the second half by getting on the board here, and it's 30-8, which is fantastic. We're set for kickoff. And Giacomo kicks it, onside kick. And it's covered cleanly by 52 from Saugus. They'll take over the ball at midfield. We're going to call out some defensive players here. Okay, we have Alec Grande on the nose. We have Colin Donahue in there as well. Josh Robichard, the other nose guard. Alex DiNapoli and Jesse Daugherty as the defensive ends. And we'll wave to the crowd. Go ahead and pan down on the crowd. We got we'll go to the Reading fans who are cheering on the team here and very excited. Shotgun snap to the left side. And kind of bowls over our guys for a few yards. Maybe a 5-yard pickup. It'll be second and 6. We'll pan to the crowd. This isn't as good as when we're home, Todd, though, because at home we can look right over and we can see the sides of the crowd, but this time we just see the back of the heads.
Mrs. Hennessy.
Yep, Julie Rainbow out there as well. Maria Puelli, she's the only one we can see right now, the only one looking the right way.
We got a flag on.
And now we got the next play. Second and 6 for Saugus. Shotgun snap. Quarterback keeper, number 53, he's got some running room. I think he's the one that scored the touchdown. He's pretty quick. And they'll have a 3rd down and 2. 3rd and short for Saugus. Shotgun, hands it up to the left side. And they're gonna bowl it up there for a 1st down. They're strong up front, Todd.
Defense really coming through today.
Yep.
The winning 50-50 raffle ticket with a prize of $75 is 4155.
Yeah, you're right, Todd. The defense has been really strong today. I'm sure Coach Puelli and all the coaches are proud of what they've been doing here. Dominating play. Let's hope they can keep it going. They threw it to no one. It looks like maybe he threw it away. His receiver fell down, it looks like. So it's going to be 2nd and 10 as Rowan Manahan checks into the game. Alec Grande checks out. Got the cheerleaders going here. Oh, we just missed the chair. It was a great chair. We can promise you that that was a great chair that you just missed. We saw it. We got to the camera late during a play. 2nd and 10. Amon Centrella playing linebacker, calling out some of the... He looks like he's the mic out there right now. Shotgun snap, 53 is going to keep it, as he's done a lot today. And Redding is... I think they knew about this guy from the last game, and they're ready for him. It seems like Rocco is shadowing him. Marsharelli is wherever that kid's going. And many other players watching him, too. 3rd and 11 for Saugus. With 6 minutes to go in the 3rd period, the clock's ticking fast here. A lot of runs. Well, he's throwing now. And a great tackle. I think that's Alex DiNapoli. Was it Alex? Yeah, Alex DiNapoli. Great play by him.
Yeah, Coach Marsharelli.
What'd he say? What did Coach Marsharelli say?
Alex.
Yep. Coach Marsharelli doesn't need a microphone, that's for sure. Fourth down for Saugus, 4th and 20. Fourth and 20 at the Reading team is pretty close to the line of scrimmage. He's looking deep. He has an open receiver, but he's down. So they'll take over on downs, another defensive stand. I can only think of one time that our defense looked like they didn't do well. This is just great performance all the way around on defense. Offense comes onto the field. Okay, 1st and 10, Marsharelli's the lone setback, shotgun snap to Murphy. We have Stroud out left. He's rolling left. He has an open man. It's Stroud over, oh! He is fouled. He is tackled before the ball get there. That was such an obvious call. He knew he was beat, and I think he just probably made the smart play of just taking down
that
Ryan.
So deep. That was a tough one to get on camera.
Yep.
Tough to follow that one.
Yeah, that was a nice throw by Murphy. So that's going to be at the spot of the foul, and Redding will take over the ball at Saugus' 35-yard line. Pass interference moves the ball all the way to the 41-yard line. I thought it was further down. Maybe it's a different kind of call here. He has an open man. Aiden Beckenius cuts it back to the middle, makes the first guy miss. Gets a couple yards.
I got faked on that one.
Oh, Coach Todd got faked out. The cameraman got faked out if you didn't see it.
Rocco had it. Good job, Coach. job, coaches.
It's going to be 2nd and 9. We have Jack Ramo checking into the game. Out right, I think we have split out life. Right, I think we have Max Leone. Back in Houston, the slot. Handoff up the middle. Okay, we have DeCourcy checking into the game. Puelli checking into the game. Nope. That was Carter Lerner that was split out right. Now we have Topier on the right. Puelli split out left. Looks like we're going to the shotgun. And Rocco, the lone running back. Back in Houston, the slot. Murphy rolls left. He has an open man. And that's Jesse Daugherty, the big tight end. I think he got a first down. They call it a first down. They're moving the chains. Jesse Daugherty makes another big play. Okay, after a big pickup by Jesse Daugherty. Was that slow to get up? But nice play. He's got good hands. Murphy under center. And it's a quarterback keeper. And he moves the pile. Maybe gets about 6 or 7 yards. They caught him napping right on the nose tackle there. You wonder if he has the option to do that if he knows there's nobody on his nose guard or it's kind of weak up front. So it was a smart play. Murphy under center. He's looking to his left. He has Iapika. No, Beckenhuis. Beckenhuis is still pumping his legs, trying to get some yards out of that. Maybe got a couple, one or two. It's going to bring up a 3rd down. So it's 30-8. With 2 minutes and 25 seconds to go in the 3rd quarter. And Reading moving down the field again. They're at the 20-yard line. 3rd and short. Murphy in shotgun, and it looks like he has Kobe Goodchild to his right. He's looking to throw, makes a pump fake, has an open man, and that's Beckenhuis to her touchdown. No, it's Iapika. Iapika. Giacomo Iapika for the touchdown. Murphy made a great pump fake and drew in the defensive backs, and Iapika got himself wide open for a big touchdown. Nice connection, and that takes him 36-8. What a play. They are just clicking on offense on all cylinders today, Todd. Running and throwing. Yeah, it's everything is working. The sneaks. Fantastic play. Can you believe we lost to this team just a month or so ago? It's surprising. I mean, this is just a dominant performance.
They've been working hard.
Yep, working hard in practice. They were prepared. I know he had, Coach Marsharelli had all the kids watching the film from the loss they had to Saugus earlier in the year. And I know practice was very focused on this team all week, and it's, boy, it's paying off. And the defense as well. Offense and defense, special teams, everything's working. They had the onside kick. It's all going well. It's a pitch to Rocco Marsharelli, and he's going to power it into the end zone. And this time, they're going to finally give us one. I think we scored on all 3 of the extra points, but they gave us that one finally. And so the score is 37-8 with 2 minutes to go. Giacomo Iapika getting set to kick off. He looks like he has a little bit more pep in his step here, setting up for kickoff. You notice that, Todd? After that awesome, that awesome touchdown pass. Pass reception.
6 points for number 6.
Yep, nice pass, nice reception. 6 for 6, that's right. 6 points for number 6. Deep kickoff. Oh, it's over his head. It's a loose ball. He picks it up, and he's swarm tackled. Alex DiNapoli, Rocco Marsharelli, Max Leone on the tackle. It's hard to know anything that's gone. Are we off for one? 1st and 10 for Saugus. Almost nothing has gone wrong for Reading today except that one run that was a big run, maybe a 40-yard run by Saugus for a touchdown. Almost everything else has gone our way. Big tackle. Aiden Beckenhuis came in and made a big hit there. Ben Wright's checking in as a defensive back, giving Kobe Goodchild a rest here. Clearly, this team was ready to play today. Thomas Fratto giving Jesse Daugherty a break at the left defensive end or outside linebacker. No, it was the defensive end. And it's going to be, I think that's a second down, isn't it? It says first down on the flag, but I think it's second a second down. Yeah. Quarterback keeping the left side, nothing there. It's going to be another, maybe a third and 10. Third down and 10 for Saugus. And this dominating performance by Redding. Shotgun. Three running backs right around him. And it's a keeper by number 53. Thomas Fratto almost makes a tackle in the backfield. And a big hit by Aiden Beckenhuis. He's had a couple really big hits on this series. And it's going to be fourth down at about five. Okay, we have Max Loney checking in the game. James Murphy coming off. Fourth down and four for Saugus. 41 seconds to go in the third quarter. Like Puelli covering the slot, Leone covering cornerback position, covering the wide receiver. Shotgun snap, number 53 has the ball in the air, and it's incomplete. A lot of guys covering there, too. We had Ben Wright and Max Leone and Aiden Beckenhuis swarming that ball. So Redding takes over on downs. The offense comes on the field. We have Max Leone split out right. Looks like Carter Learned out left. Marciarelli under center. And who's our big halfback there right now? Is that Jesse Daugherty as the halfback? He goes right up on the scrimmage. Looks like Ben Wright is the deep back. It's a handoff right up to Jesse Daugherty, right up the middle. And he's going to power up for like 6-7 yards. Nice power running. Run. Big power running. A couple blocks up there front. Thomas Fratto in on the blocking. Second and about four for Redding. Second and four for Redding. Looks like Jesse Daugherty still in the backfield. No, it's not Jesse Daugherty. Who is that? It's number 72. It's Sean Murphy they have running the ball.
We had 70 running earlier.
Oh, was it 70? It was Brady Swanson, and now it's Sean Murphy. And now they have Colin Donahue coming in. I think they're giving some linemen a chance to carry the ball. Is that what's going on here?
Game plan.
It is. Now they have Colin Donahue. They're giving linemen a chance to carry the ball. This is exciting. They'll love this. They'll love to have this video. I would guess that Colin Donahue's going to get this ball, and he does. And he's running to the right. And he's got big yards and a first down. So these guys are running the ball great. So it was Brady Swanson, was it Jesse Daugherty, Sean Murphy, and now Colin Donahue. All these guys are running the ball. And looks like Josh Robichaud is getting in to the line. He's getting into the running back's position here. So, and Rocco's telling these guys, these offensive linemen, exactly where to stand to get the ball. And I think they're going to get it. Josh Robichaud right up the middle. He's going to take it. And they're enjoying a chance to run the ball. This is great. This is a lot of fun for the players. Get some guys in that haven't had a chance to run the ball. Eamon Centrella checks in. I would guess he's going to get that same chance, too. This is a lot of fun.
Fun for the announcer, too.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Fun for announcing, too. Eamon Centrella in that spot where he might get the ball as well. He takes it. And now I think the Saugus team is starting to see what's going on. They're figuring out that they're plugging in every lineman that's on the Redding team, and they're handing it up right up the middle. So
they're chewing time off the clock, too.
Yep, but I don't think Coach Marciarelli or the other coaches care at all. Like, with this kind of lead, I'm sure they're happy to do this for the rest of the game. And it looks like Dylan Sweetser is getting that chance right now. Another one of we've seen some great play by Dylan, especially on the defensive line. One of the hardest guys to block, and makes a lot of tackles. Right up the middle to Dylan Sweetser. He's running the ball and gets a few yards. It'll be fourth down and that's the end of the quarter. That's the game. I don't remember switching sides, Todd. It still says third quarter on the clock. It did seem like a long third quarter, but I don't remember when it switched. So that was the game.
Caught up in the moment.
Yeah, the broadcast team got caught up in the moment. But what a great win for Reading. And very exciting to have a playoff victory. We got Tom Dolan on this side of the camera. And what a great win. Every facet of the game, they dominated. And it was great to see some of the linemen get a chance to carry the ball. You don't usually get that chance. So great win. And we'll see them moving on. We don't know who we're going to play next, Todd, but it looks like we'll be playing probably midweek. And wouldn't it be great to get a chance to go after Westford? They've avenged the Saugus loss. If they can avenge that Westford loss and win the conference, I think this team would be very psyched.
Well,
big win.
The kids followed through and they executed.
They followed through. They went with the coach's plan, and very exciting win.
Get them on film here.
We're proud of this team winning a playoff game.
There we go.
And here they are celebrating.
Yeah.
Great win by the team. Todd just zooming in on the kids. Cheerleaders and the fans dispersing. Great win.
All right, coach, here we go.
Get the fans. And now we have the B team coming up to do their broadcasting.
And the fans.
All right. Well, signing off from Wilmington. Say